This is a video about how Apple iBooks platform extends the ePub format. This video gives an overview of the iBooks file format and compares it to the ePub format. It also gives an overview of Kids Love Bugs, which is an early iBooks file. iTunes extends the ePub open standard, makes it close, and adds JavaScript and a few other things. The book I'm going to give you an overview of is called Kids Love Bugs. It's the first self-published iBooks 2 file sold on iTunes, and it's $2.99. My name is Jeremy Kemp. I'm a lecturer at San Jose State's School of Library and Information Science. The iTunes iBooks 2 file format extends the EPUB. That's from the International Digital Publishing Forum. This format, the multi-touch book format, includes template-based layouts. There are 6 templates I'll be showing you. You can control the size of the columns and add multi-column layouts. A few things about iPad iBooks. You have to sell them through the iTunes producer. If you create an iBook, you can give it away for free, but if you make money from it using digital rights management, you have to use the iTunes setup. Apple takes 30% off the top, depending on the market. So this is the set of books on my bookshelf. Some of these are the professional publishers, the Life on Earth, DK Natural History Insects. This is the book I want to take a look at, my Kids Love Bugs book. So I'm going to open it up, see the cover.
Dr. Kemp's Kids Love Bugs.
That's called the intro media file, and then it immediately jumps to chapter 1. And you can see here there's a chapter header page. Here's a book with multiple pages in the section, in the chapter. So I'm going to open up the chapter header page, and this is an interactive widget, the gallery widget. All the widgets allow you to expand to full page. Here you can see a keynote animation with hotspots. So these are linked within the slideshow. So I'm going to start it up. So individual slides come with a sound when I navigate through. So I'm going to go to the next page. This is another widget. Click on individual pieces within the photo and it zooms in. Finally, a video file, M4V file, in the page. So I'm going to shrink this page down. You can see the layout of the book here along the bottom. Here's a different format page.
This has been Jeremy Kemp from San Jose State School of Library and Information Science.